Hello, we are Yıldız Rover team from Yıldız Technical University in Istanbul. We are an interdisciplinary robotics team comprising over 50 members from different engineering and science departments. We are proud to introduce to you our third generation rover, Gökmen.
The rover chassis consists of T-slot aluminium profiles, ensuring lightness, durability and easy modification. Positioned at the rear, the differential bar in the rocker suspension system is made of aluminium profiles to guarantee high bending strength and vehicle stability. This design choice contributes to a more balanced ride with reduced forex pressure. The rover exhibits the capability to climb up to 45-degree slope with brushed DC motors generating 20 Nm torque and airless TPU tires. The drive system enables the rover to traverse harsh conditions efficiently.
6 degrees of freedom robotic arm that utilizes a combination of brushed, brushless and servo motors is capable of carrying loads up to 5 kilograms. The robotic arm excels in providing high precision thanks to cycloidal, differential bevel gear and belt pulley mechanism composed of cast polyamide, aluminum and TPU. The flexible two-fingered adaptive gripper is capable of providing full rotation. The gripper is designed for ensuring both parallel and rounded grip along with wide grasping ability.
We choose 6 serial 13 parallel Li-ion battery pack to safely provide sufficient current and voltage to all electronic equipment in rover's electronics box. For safety, we used battery management system, which protects the battery from undesirable conditions. We designed custom-made PCBs such as power distribution, motor driver, robotic arm, switching and encoder with STM32 series microcontrollers on them. Our power distribution board has features such as reverse polarity protection, INA current sensor and fuses at the power outputs. These designs provide overall reliability, better control and durability to the rover. Considering emergency scenarios, an easily accessible emergency stop button has been placed on the rover, which can unconditionally shut it down.
We apply a 5.8 GHz omnidirectional antenna between the rover and base station and utilize LoRa modules for long-distance communication. The CAN bus and UART protocols were chosen for wired communication in the rover.
We improve our previous work based on deep reinforced learning based autonomy with three-dimensional analysis support, so we can easily travel in rigid and sloped conditions. For the real-time location accuracy of our rover, a long short-term memory-based sensor fusion model that's combining Z-Stereo camera, Biona 55 IMU, real encoders and RTK GNSS was designed and trained in real-life conditions. Combined location and motion data are brought together in integrated QT-based and a real map-supported mission planner. Planner can tolerate connection interruptions with the ability of to automatically switch connection frequencies.
Thanks to the image datasets we have created, we can recognize object and oracle levels, instantly determine their location and relative angles and include them in autonomy. The ARM software combines DH transformations and inverse kinematics calculations and tested and verified in the bullet physics environments with the PID algorithm on the Arduino by communicating with ROS.
We expanded our life detection investigations in the purpose of searching for extinct, and no life by searching for the organic, inorganic, and biochemical and microbial activity of the rocks and soils. We also detect the suitability of the atmosphere by analyzing several gas levels. We collect the soil by using a drill mechanism, distributing it to cuvettes in the revolver, mixing with distilled water, filtered, then the chemical tests flow in the cuvettes. Finally, suitable sensors will be used such as MPK, pH, humidity and methane gas to determine the soil conditions. We've added 4 colorimetric tests in our life detection mechanism, Bradford region to investigate the presence of protein, Sudan T region for lipids, providing important origin of the organic matter, Benedict region to search for glucose, and finally methylene blue that reacts in presence of perchlorates. We observe the soil samples by using thin layer chromatography, a solid liquid adsorption to separate the soil's components.
With our new UV visible spectrophotometer, we are also detecting the components of the soil such as chlorophylls, carotenoids, interpreting them according to their absorbance.
We also analyze rock and soil types by using a microscope, Munsell color chart and also a sedimentary archive.